हेलो चिल्ड्रन, गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू. वेलकम टू द वर्चुअल क्लास प्रेजेंटेड बाय जेट किड्स. सो सी डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे इन द साइंस पीरियड वी आर गोइंग टू सी यस द टॉपिक दैट इज लेसन नंबर 7 सेफ्टी रूल. सी स्टूडेंट, दिस टॉपिक वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो ओनली. ओके, मीन्स वी हैव स्टार्टेड द लेसन नंबर 7 इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो एंड इन दैट व्हाट वी लर्न सेफ्टी रूल्स एट होम, सेफ्टी रूल्स इन स्कूल, सेफ्टी रूल्स इन द प्ले ग्राउंड. नाउ दिस इज द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ लेसन नंबर 7, दैट इज द सेफ्टी रूल्स. सो इन द सेकेंड पार्ट वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द सेफ्टी रूल्स विच वी हैव टू फॉलो ऑन द रोड, इन व्हीकल्स एंड इन द स्विमिंग पूल. सो दीज रिमेनिंग पॉइंट्स वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न इन दिस वीडियो. ओके, सो लेट अस स्टार्ट. सो ऑन द रोड विच सेफ्टी रूल्स यू हैव टू फॉलो that see road accidents happen when the people do not follow the traffic rules. Number A, people do not follow the traffic rules. When if we follow the traffic rules and if everybody just follow the traffic rules, then what happened, then the accident will not happen. Okay, so if we follow the rules, then the accident will not happen, but people do not follow, that's why the accidents happen. Okay, number B, drivers drive carelessly or very fast. They are always in hurry to go somewhere very fast. Okay, with high speed it is not possible to drive safely. So we have to maintain the proper speed of our vehicle also. Okay, so and sometimes it happens that the driver feels sleepy. Okay, so that time also the accident can happen. So drivers have to take more care. Okay, because he is driver and he is driving the car or bus or vehicle or any transport. Okay, so if he will drive his vehicle very carefully, then it will not happen that the accident can happen. Okay, number C, we do not walk carefully. Yes, we do not walk carefully. If we walk carefully, if we follow all the rules which we have to follow on the road, then the accident will not happen. So in this way, on the road accidents happen because of this generally three reasons. Okay, so see, now what we have to do is, do's means what we have to do, what is correct, what we have to follow. So see the do's. Number A, be alert and careful on the road. If we have to save or we have to protect ourselves from any accident, then what we have to do, we have to be always alert and be careful on the road. And number B, walk only on the footpath. Okay, so what we have to do when we are walking on the road, then we have to walk only on the footpath. If there is a no footpath, then walk on the right side of the road facing the traffic. See what I am saying, facing the traffic. When our face is towards the traffic, then that right side we have to walk. Okay, if there is not footpath, but if there is a footpath, then you have to walk on the footpath only. So these things we have to do, that's why these are the do's. Now what we so see the picture. Okay, so see that teacher and the children, they are following the traffic rule, they are walking on the footpath. In this way we have to follow the rule. Next thing, So see student, what we have to what don'ts in the column, don'ts means we should not do these things, the following things. So number A, never play or run on the road. Means we should not play, okay, or we should not run on the road for our safety. Number B, do not go near the street dogs. So whichever the dogs present on the street or on the road, we should not go near to them or other stray animals. Now what is mean by stray animals? The animals which are lost or which and the owner is not, and they don't have any owner, they are lost and they are wandering here on the road. Okay, so near that animal so we should not go. Okay, because they are dangerous and they can hurt us any time. Okay, we should not beat them also, but we should not go near to them also. Okay, number C, never walk on the railway track. Okay, so never walk on the railway tracks. So otherwise we have to face many problems. Okay, so see the pictures. Okay, see in the first picture that boy is playing on the road and that the girl is walking on the track. So these both the things are wrong. So they put a cross in the box. Okay. So these are the wrong things, and that these things we should not do. That's why it comes in the don'ts. Okay. So I hope you understood this part. So let us move to the next part. So see, safety rules while crossing the road. What are the safety rules while crossing the road? Okay. So see, before crossing, look to your right. See, what is our heading? Safety rules while crossing the road means how you are going to cross the road. So see, they have given us the instruction how to cross the road. So before crossing, look to your right hand side, okay, then your left hand side, okay, and once again to your right, okay, and make sure that no vehicle is coming close. You have to check, that means you have to check, see right hand side, left hand side, again right hand side, and you have to check there is no vehicle is coming then close to you. Okay, if the road is clear, okay, if the road is clear, then cross the road, okay, and always cross the road at zebra crossing only. So see, if the road is clear, no vehicle is there, no car is there, no nothing is there, then you have to cross the road by using the zebra crossing. Okay, zebra crossing means already you know that there is one mark, okay, like black and white stripes are there, okay, that we can call it as a zebra crossing, and you already know it. If you don't know, then you have to, when you are traveling or going somewhere, you have to ask your parent, please mama or dada, show me the zebra crossing. Okay, otherwise in Google also you can search, or in your book there is a picture of zebra crossing. Okay, so you can see that also. There are traffic lights, okay, for the people to use the zebra crossing. So there are the traffic lights for the people, okay, for us there are the traffic lights, okay, and which put by our government, okay, to use the zebra crossing. These are called pedestrian lights. What we call to these lights, we call it as a pedestrian lights. There are traffic lights, okay, for the people to use the zebra crossing, and these lights are called pedestrian lights. So see the picture, okay, so this is the picture of pedestrian lights. Okay, I hope you understood. Now see, so see the next part. Do not cross the road when the pedestrian light is red. So you saw the picture, yes. So do not cross the road when the pedestrian light is red. Okay. So if the pedestrian light is red, then you should not cross the road. You have to wait because red sign is of dangerous. Okay. Cross the road when the pedestrian light is green. And green means it is like green signal, means you can walk, you can move. Okay. So cross the road when the pedestrian light is green. Okay. Red light indicates stop and green light indicates go. Once again, I am going to show you the picture. So see the picture once again properly. See, red light means stop, and green, see the picture of green light, that person is walking, yes. So green means you have to move, okay, red means stop. So I hope you understood. Red light indicates stop and green light indicates go. So let us see the next part. See the picture, huh? This is the pedestrian light, okay, and the girl and the boy is crossing the road, and see, they are crossing on the zebra crossing. So see, those who haven't seen the picture of zebra crossing, they can see in this picture. See, the boy and the girl, they are crossing the road using zebra crossing. Okay, so let us see the next. So in vehicles, which rules you have to follow? So see, number A, stand in a queue while waiting for or boarding the bus. Okay, when you are going to travel by the bus, then first of all, before entering, you have to stand in a queue while waiting or for boarding the bus. Number B, stay seated while the bus is moving. So do not stand up, okay, do not move, do not walk in the moving bus. Okay, so stay seated while the bus is moving. Next rule C, which you have to follow in the vehicles, talk softly. Okay, do not shout, do not make noise in the bus. Okay, talk softly so that the bus driver can concentrate on driving. Driver should not disturb by our louder talk. Okay, so whenever you are in the bus, you have to talk softly so that the bus driver can concentrate on his driving. And this is very 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 important rule, okay, that you have to follow. And D, डू नॉट लीन आउट ऑफ अ मूविंग बस, यू शुड नॉट टेक योर हैंड ओके और यू शुड नॉट टेक योर हेड आउट ऑफ द विंडो आउट ऑफ द डोर ओके इन द मूविंग बस ओके. सो डू नॉट लीन आउट ऑफ ए मूविंग बस. ई ऑलवेज वेयर अ सीट बेल्ट वेन यू आर ट्रैवलिंग इन अ कार. इफ यू आर ट्रैवलिंग इन अ कार देन यू हैव टू ऑलवेज वेयर अ सीट बेल्ट, स्पेशली इफ यू आर सीटिंग ऑन द फ्रंट सीट. इफ यू आर सीटिंग ऑन द फ्रंट सीट दैट टाइम यू इट इज़ कंपल्सरी टू वेयर अ सीट बेल्ट. इट इज़ फॉर योर प्रोटेक्शन, इट इज़ फॉर योर सेफ्टी ओके. सो दीज आर द रूल्स दैट यू हैव टू फॉलो इन द व्हीकल्स. आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड ओके. सो सी द पिक्चर, सी द पिक्चर ऑफ बस स्टॉप. बस इज देयर एंड द चिल्ड्रन, दिस इज अ स्कूल बस बिकॉज द ऑल द चिल्ड्रन आर देयर ओके. एंड सी दे आर हैविंग देयर बैग्स एंड बुक्स ओके. एंड द कलर ऑफ द बस इज ऑल्सो येल्लो. सो दिस इज द स्कूल बस ओके. सो यू हैव टू स्टैंड इन अ क्यू ओके. वे इफ देयर आर मोर चिल्ड्रन एट योर स्टॉप देन यू हैव टू फॉलो दिस रूल्स ओके एंड ऑल द अदर रूल्स ऑल्सो. सो आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड दिस पॉइंट. Now, what are the rules that you have to follow in the swimming pool? Okay, so the rules which you have to follow in the swimming pool. A. Swim only in the presence of an adult. This is very, very, very important thing that if the adults are there, that time only you have to swim. B. Use floats or rubber tubes if you are learning how to swim. Swim. If you know the swimming, then no problem. But if you don't know how to swim or you are learning, that time you have to use floats or rubber tubes. Okay, I will show you the picture in the next slide. What the picture of floats and rubber tubes. Okay, see, never go to the deep end of a pool. You should not go in the deep. Okay, then otherwise you can you have to face the problem. Okay, then you cannot protect yourself. Okay, so you have to swim. Okay, on the upper part of the water only. Next, number D. Do not swim in the tanks or ponds. You should not swim in the tanks. Don't do experiments, okay? Do not swim in the tanks or ponds. It is not safe, okay? So these are the few rules that you have to follow in the swimming pool, okay? So see the picture. It is a picture of swimming pool and the coach is present or elder is present. And see the children, okay? They are having the floats, okay? Or the rubber tubes, okay? So in this way, you have to follow these rules, okay? And in the presence of elder only you are going to swim. Now watch out. So see, watch out means what you have to do. In case you are hurt, okay, in case you are hurt, do not panic means don't take a tension. Keep calm, keep yourself calm, quiet, inform an adult. Then what you have to do, next step is, first of all, don't take tension, don't be panic, keep yourself calm, inform an adult, and you will be given first aid treatment if required. First aid treatment means the first aid box is present everywhere in your house, also in your school also, or in many places, okay? So the treatment which before going to hospital, whatever the initial treatment is there, that we give by using the first aid box. That treatment is called as first aid treatment, okay? If if you need the first aid treatment, then elders can give it to you. That's why you have to inform to elders, okay? So I hope you understood this point. Okay, so see, let's say together column is there. Okay, so you have to say after me. Let's say together: accidents, injury, traffic rules, footpath, zebra crossing, pedestrian lights. So all the spellings you have to write 3 times in your science notebook, and you have to learn all these spellings. Okay, now next point is keywords. Okay, so what are the keywords? Safety rules. Okay, so see, measures that are taken to stay away from harm. What are the safety rules? Safety rules means the measures, okay, that are taken to stay away from harm. So what is meant by zebra crossing? So see, so zebra crossing means black and white stripes painted on the road for safe crossing. Okay, zebra crossing means black and white stripes painted on the road for safe crossing. Okay, pedestrians means what? Pedestrians means people walking on the road. People, those are walking on the road. And the next and the last point is barbed wire. Means strong wire with a short sharp points on it. Barbed wire means strong wire with a short, okay, sharp points on it. Okay, students. So I hope you understood this. So you have to write all these keywords and the meanings, difficult words and their meanings in science notebook one time. Okay, and you have to learn these definitions. Okay, so let us take the summary of this lesson, and this is the last point. In short, we will see what we learn in this lesson number 7, that is the safety rules. So the in short, in the 5 points, they have given us the summary. Number 1, safety rules save us from accidents. That's why we have to follow. Okay, number 2, we should follow safety rules at home, in school, in the playground, okay, on the road, in a vehicle, and in the swimming pool. Number 3, we should not play with matchsticks and sharp things, okay. Number 4, we should swim in the presence of an adult only. And number 5 and the last, in case you are hurt, immediately inform an adult. It is your duty to inform your mother, father, or teacher, anybody, or your elder brother or sister, so they can take care of you. They can give us they can give you a first aid treatment also. So I hope, dear students, you understood this lesson. And what is the name of our lesson? That is the lesson number 7, safety rules. Okay, students. Okay, children. Thank you. Stay home. Stay safe. Bye. Have a nice day.